time. Now I request Dr. Baldev Raj to give his discussion points. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Bhujangrao. It was a pleasure to be with our colleagues. My colleagues in the session on quality and validation were Himadri Ghosh, K.N. Karan, P.K. Sharma, Dr. Banu Prasad, and myself. And as you see, we were five Pandavs. And we didn't need sixth one. So it was very good that we could discuss a few things. We realized one difficulty, that quality as perceived or quality as built into many of the products and processes which were talked were not really defined or were not cared. You look at, for example, a comparison with what Dr. Jayadeep presented, some of the products taken from all over the world and including India. They were all to the specifications. They had been packaged very well. There is no pride in showing a rural background as a dirty, unmanaged, that is not rural India. So I think we have to be very clear about the quality, its perceiving and its building and its checking. Having said that, we identified that there are five or six things which we can do. One is the culture of the quality, which comes free, but which is most important part of the quality, that every action you do, it reflects your commitment to a product or a process. This can be done through change leaders, as Himadri Ghosh told us, and these change leaders should work very closely with the people who are doing inclusive manufacturing products and processes, and these change leaders should be very carefully taught as to some things in the quality can be built free of cost, some can be saving cost if you build in quality, and some can be at the cost. So these change agents must know all these things. Second, most of the products which we want to really do the value addition, they can be transformed to the virtual products so that all over the country and all over the world, the people can see that what does this product consist of, right from materials to the tools they use, the tradition of the skill sets, the concepts, and with the advantage of the augmented virtual reality, many things can be brought out. And this can be a portal, in fact, of the all the Indian products which we considered are part of inclusive manufacturing. And this can be even funded through advertisements at some stage, but in the beginning it would have to be done through certain mechanism. Many of us were narrating our experiences, and we were finding that research is done at the high level by the scholars. Diploma holders and technicians do the implementation, and then finally it is most of the people who are not even skilled, so as to say they don't have the formal degree, but they are excellent people, they do it. So we must convert our best practices to do's and don'ts, and we have used this do's and don'ts practice in atomic energy, space and defense, in very high technology it works, because finally these are the people. When you see the success of a space shuttle, it is finally sometimes done by a very casual worker who has been brought in to do a part of that job. But they know very well that finally space shuttle would succeed because of this culture can be brought into that. Then we also said that, you see, most of the things are related to cleanliness. To my mind, only country which gives the right recognition to cleanliness is Japan, where at undergraduate level and elective levels, there is a full course on cleanliness. Cleanliness can add a lot of value, can bring the product quality, can cause the pride that this product has been done. Surfaces, which also add to the cleanliness, can add the value. Then quality today has to be through the life cycle. It is absolutely no doubt in anybody's mind. It has to satisfy the requirements of sustainability. It has to satisfy the requirement of reuse and things like that. So can we think of that all these pieces sold in millions and billions sometime. There is a mechanism to reuse so that the minerals are conserved, the costs are brought down, and they are reused. But then if you have to do that, then you have to write a different quality practices for that. What quality products, quality specifications are there with virgin materials, they are not applicable when you reuse them or recycle them. So you have to write a fresh things and all that. But that can be, it's a challenge, but it can be done. So in short, there is a very good material for us as next steps. But we have learned from these presentations, it's all amalgamated into what. Then we are thinking that everywhere if you have to tell a story, people say, give me example. Amul is a great example of inclusive manufacturing. Yesterday, Unilever presented a great example of tea. Diamond cutters in Gujarat are the great example of the quality work at the highest level. Similarly, if you look at Mahabalipuram, where I spent most of my life at Kalpakkam, there are schools which teach the granite sculpturing, and the sculptures they make from tiny size to huge sizes, they are sold all over the world. In fact, they have a booking over years what their sculptures can do, but it is done in a very formal way. Informalization is converted to a formal building up of the things and all that. So we have plenty of things to do, but doable with the kind of competence which we have. And thanks for the opportunity.